Working as a nurse in her rural Nigerian village and at Datao faced more than her share of challenges, but delivering babies by torchlight was always hard. Off-grid for years, her Sabon Gida village relied on diesel generators or lamps and, like millions of other Africans, Datao often got no light at all. But a year ago, Datao's village in north-central Nasarawa state hooked up to a solar-powered mini-grid, supplying half of her community's households and most businesses with almost constant electricity. Sabon Gida now has more light at times than Lagos, Nigeria's economic capital, where many get by on around half a day's power, times much less from the unstable network.
When the woman comes to give birth here, it's very difficult for us because we don't get light. We are using torch light. So that day I'm very stressful because of that torch light, using torch light, I'm pressing. So doing even giving the injection without a light, it will still be difficult to us. So with that light, we are enjoying it.
Nearly 600 million Africans live without electricity access, and in Nigeria alone, that figure is 90 million, about 40% of the population in the continent's most populous nation. And while Africa may have the most potential to generate solar power, according to the International Energy Agency, the continent lags behind installed capacity. Tripling renewable energy, including solar, will be on the agenda for COP28 climate talks next month in Dubai.
So there are 600 million Africans without access to electricity, and Nigeria is the largest, has the highest rates of this unelectrified population across Africa. Nigeria is also the largest potential market for mini-grids, and so mini-grids are a key solution in electrifying at least 30% of the unelectrified population. So Nigeria has the potential, but it is being hampered by a range of constraints, including financial and policy constraints at the moment.
Africa is responsible for the smallest amount of greenhouse gas emissions, but it is often impacted the most while also under pressure to avoid fossil-based development. Solar mini-grids are not a low-scale solution. The World Bank and IEA see them as one of the most viable ways to get fossil-free access to electricity for rural sub-Saharan Africa. In a report this year, the bank said solar mini-grid use expanded from only 500 installed in 2010 to more than 3,000 installed now. Another 9,000 are seen coming online in a few years. Sabon Gida is one community in a private-public initiative involving the World Bank and US-based mini-grid maker Husk Power Systems with the country's Rural Electrification Agency. Today, generators have been abandoned. Everyone relies on power from the mini grid. It is what everyone uses. People now use the electricity and everyone wants to be connected because they can use it for their needs at home without the trouble of going somewhere else. Solar is now the cheapest source of energy for utility scale power, an attractive proposition for Africa where poor investment and badly maintained power networks often mean limited energy.